So we started with the next address generator. So first of all, what will be present in this control memory means necessary control signals has to be generated. Same yesterday I have given example like a brain. So you should you will be getting some kind of a signal saying that you are hungry, so you need to drink some water now, you are like that. So in the same way, the control signals has to be generated so that a processor will know whether it has to do a read operation or whether it has to do a write operation, from which particular location everything will be done by the control unit. So for that you should know the flow. For example, if you're cooking any if you want to cook a rice, then you should know that how much quantity you need to take for two members and how much water you have to use. Everything you have to know. In the same way, in a control memory, if it wants to generate a sequence to signals, then you need to maintain an address, next address generator, so that it maintains in a sequence. Okay. So, but the problem here is, so first by default, you will be getting the micro program to be executed will be fetch. It has to be fetched. Next to decode. Then after decoding, which set of micro programs has to be executed? Can anyone? After decoding, control signals, which control signals has to be generated after decoding? So this is one micro program where you will be having a set of micro instructions. Decode is one kind of a micro program where you'll be having some set of micro instructions for that. Next, after performing a decoding, next step is what? After decoding, yes, micro operations. So that indicates after decoding, it knows that what is available inside this opcode. Okay, so let us suppose inside this opcode, if it is add, then add set of micro operation, micro programs has to be executed. And if it is suppose subtraction, then subtraction related micro programs has to be executed. So for that, the external input is what? When it takes this input is when it is sequence. So let me go for the just. Okay, so here let us consider this is your control memory. Okay, so you will be having a micro program. So this one will be fetch and fetch micro program, and this one is decode. Next one is, let us consider opcode. But in opcode you'll be having so many, right? And subtraction and something. Why? Because it is arithmetic and logical operations, so you'll be having logical operations also, or increment, all those. So for those, all those you should have a micro program. So here I am writing as and, here as sub, and the other one as mul. Okay, so now let us suppose this is an instruction where in this is present in random access memory, and this is present in read only memory. Why? Because this is your control memory. If executed, it generates a control signals, but if this executed, it generates a necessary operations whether it performs addition or subtraction, right? So for that, in from this memory, if the instructions has to read from this, means the control signals has to be generated. For that, this set of in micro operations has to be micro programs which are present inside this has to be executed. So to in order, so for that we are maintaining an address sequence generator control address register and 100. Next, it places 101, 102, like that. But after completing fetch and the decode, decoded, it knows that it is opcode is null. So what it has to do, it okay, so multiplication. So let us consider this address is, this is the first address which is called 600. Okay, so this the control address sequencer has to place 600 so that it comes to here. So in order to do that, what we are doing is we are taking the input from external, this side. Okay, so from the actual instruction, program instruction will be having an opcode, right? So this opcode we are placing inside a control address register. So this one. So for that, first it places in the sequencer, then from that it goes to control address register. Okay, so that's the reason there where all this will be removed and directly it goes to MUL micro program, where it consists of a set of micro instructions. So for that, what we need to do is mapping. Concentrate. For that, what we need to do is mapping. Why mapping is required? Let us consider. Concentrate, ma. At last, second question. The same period will also be continued by me. So why we are going for mapping? So the mapping, why we are going is. See. This is your instruction, okay, the normal instruction. So initially we have considered the first unit with the size 4096 into how much, 8 or 16? First unit we have considered one memory size, right? 4096 into 16 means the 16 indicates what? 4096 data bits. Yes, ma'am. So 16 is data bits. So in the 16 bits, view remaining opcode, remain mode. Now 4096 means how many to power, how much is 4096?
Two power 12,
yes, ma'am. Very good. So 0 to 11, you'll be having an address. And the from 12 to 14 you'll be having an opcode, and the first 15th bit will be mode, so which indicates if it is 0 it is direct, if it is 1 it is indirect. So this part will be considered as an input for control memory, so that those particular the opcode micro programs has to be executed. So here we have a 3 bits here. Now we should know about the control memory size also. Okay, now let us consider the control memory sizes, where 128 into 20 means what, ma? Can anyone? 128 into 20 means what? 20 is the data. 128 is address. So 128 means 2 power how much is 128?
7.
2 power 7. Okay, so 7. Now I want an answer. So this opcode has to be placed in address. Why? Because based on this, it has to generate, it has to go to that particular address called add, and whatever if you go to that add, what will be present inside that address? Micro instruction. So this, if you go to that particular address, will have a micro instruction, so where each cell will be having a micro operation. Okay, micro operation, and the other partition is address, and the other partition is address. So micro instruction, this will be of two partitions. One is a set of micro operations and the other one is an address. So in order to take this as an external input, where we are taking from the actual instruction format, the program instruction format, so let us consider the fetch micro program is completed and decode micro program is completed for control signals. Next is opcode. So for that, it takes from the actual instruction opcode, but here it is 3 bits, but the address for control memory is 7 bits. So what we need to do is try to write a 7 bits here. Okay, so try to place how many bits that are present here as it is, and remaining initially you try to place 0, and the remaining how many zeros we require you try to place. This will become an address for that particular micro program. Okay, it will be designed in such a way that it maps in such a way that if you go to that particular address, the starting micro program of that will be a add. So let us consider this DIS add. So it has to place, so I will show the mapping diagram so that you will be, it will be clear for you. See here. Okay, so in this case, where is the address that they have considered, I will show you. See here. Okay, now in this case where we have considered just now as 4096, no, but in this case it is considered, see, I will explain this. So we'll be having two types of memories. One memory is the random access memory, which is the one, okay, random access memory. This is read-only memory where you'll be writing the program. So inside this we'll be using two registers. One is a control address register and the other one is subroutine register. So we'll be using subroutine register when there is a function call. Okay, so here the memory size it is considered is 2048. Means what? 2 power how much is 2048? 2 power 12 or 11?
12. 11. No, 11, ma'am. 11.
2 power 12 is just now we discussed. 2 power 12 means.
9, 6, 4, 0, 9,
yes, 6. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. So it is 4096. So this will be 11. So if it is 11, means how many opcode bits will be there? According to your. So it is 16 only. So you'll be having 16 bits totally. And inside that 16 bits, how many bits occupied for address? 12 or 11?
11.
Means 0 to 11 or 0 to 10?
Yes. 0 to 10, ma'am.
It's 0 to 10, this will be an address. And first bit will be opcode. This 15th bit will be opcode. And remaining, how many bits occupied for opcode, ma'am? 3 or 4?
4 bits.
Four.
Yes, 4 bits will be for opcode. So this is your opcode. Now this opcode must be mapped to the control memory address. Here the control memory size is 128 into 20. So you will be having a 20 bits. In that 20 bits, you know that we'll be having two partitions for that. One is address part and the other one is micro programs. Okay, so in this part what we are doing is the address for this will be, this is your data, and the address for this will be how many bits, ma? 128 means 2 power how much? 7 bits.
7.
Yes, 7 bits. The same, this here it is showing. See here, according to this example we'll be having a 4 bit opcode for actual machine instruction. Okay, so we need to go for mapping so that we need to go to that control. You will be having a control memory where we'll be having a set of micro operations. And so let us consider this is your micro program. This is your micro program for add. Okay, after decoding, let us suppose we have a add opcode. So for this starting address, in order to find out this starting address, we need to go for a mapping. So mapping is the actual instruction format opcode we are taking as it is, which is if we have 1011, we'll be placing 1011 from as it is. And in the initially we'll be placing 0 and the remaining places will be placing 0, so that this address will become automatically the starting address of this micro program called add. So we have designed in such a way that these addresses will be placed in such a way so that if it goes to this one, so it generates a corresponding control signal so that ALU will know that it has to perform an addition between those two operands which are mentioned in this particular address. Okay, so mapping is what. So for the previous case, in this case we have a 3 we have considered 3 bits in this case. So if you are considering 3 bits, whatever it is present in those instruction will be writing 010, and initially we need to place 0, and the remaining bits in order to make that to 7 bits, we need to consider how many zeros we want. This is about mapping, so that the address will be generated. So if you go to that address, the necessary micro program for that particular add operation, you will be going to that particular location for getting a control signals. This is about the external input, this one. Okay, so this one you are taking the input from the actual machine instruction, whatever the programs that you will be writing, like addition of two numbers or subtraction of two numbers, those will be stored inside, those instructions will be stored inside read-only memory or random access memory. The program that you are writing will be stored in RAM or ROM?
ROM.
This one. This one.
ROM only.
Read only memory. In read only memory, we'll be placing CM, control memory, ma'am. The program that you are writing in order to solve a particular task will be stored inside a random access memory. Okay, so this is about the program that you have written. This is about the program which is used, the program which it is written to generate a corresponding control signals. Okay, so this one is different, this one is different. You must understand clearly, this is used for generating a control signals. If executed, this one will not have a control signals, but it executes whatever that the code that you have mentioned in that program. Okay, so this is about the mapping, where where you will be using an opcode here, where you will be using an opcode here, so that it goes to that particular address. This is about microprogrammed control unit. Now let me go for address sequencer. So this is about address sequencer. Okay, so this is also the last repeating once again. So this explain about address sequencer means this part. This part will be clear, will be explained in depth. We are studying about the next address generator, which is called an address sequencer. Okay, so for that we'll be taking 4 inputs. We'll be taking 4 inputs. What are those 4 inputs? First one is normal incrementer. Okay, so if it see here. So this is your control memory, which is stored in read-only memory or random access memory?
Read-only memory.
Read-only memory.
Yes, yes, ma'am. So it will be stored in read-only memory. Okay. So you'll be having the address for this called 100 to 101, 102, like that. So first it starts with 100. Next it increments by 1. That is one approach. So this is one approach where it starts with the starting address and it go on increment by 1, so that it executes in sequence. So execution in sequence is one approach. So if it is in sequence, this will be selected. So we have used a multiplexer, where for those multiplexers we have given 4 inputs. One input is a normal sequence where it will be executed one by one, and the other input is subroutine register, where if there is a function call, so from a main function, so if there is a something called int I and something, some function is there, so it will not be executed, the next printf something all will not be executed, it has to go to that sum function. So for that the main program counter must not place the next address. Instead of that, it has to place the 700 address. For that, it has to generate a corresponding control signal. For that, first this has to be executed. So for that, what we need to place is the subroutine register, where the necessary micro program, if executed, it knows that the program counter should not place the next address called 102. It has to place the 700. For that, we need to execute those set of micro programs. So we are maintaining a subroutine register. So if you maintain a subroutine register, where we'll be having an address for this. So if it goes to that address, it executes this, then it knows that it has to jump from that location to the other location. Signals has to be generated. So here one is a normal approach where we are going in a sequence, and the other one is subroutine register. And then the other one is a subroutine register. When there is a subroutine calls in the program, then instead of going for the normal incrementer, it goes in this approach. And the next one is two approaches. One is conditional and the other one is unconditional. If it is a conditional, then we need to check some conditions. See here, if it is not, if we don't have any condition, simply it will be saying as go to that particular location. So without any checking whether it is true or false, in such case, directly the branch address where it has to jump, it will be selected that as an input, or else the it checks the status of that based on that. If that conditions branch logic will be present here, based on if it satisfies, then it will be given to the multiplexer as input. See here, both are considered as one input, so only four inputs will be given to the multiplexer. What are those four inputs? Is one is a normal incrementer. Next one is subroutine register, where when there is a branch jumping from one location to another based on a function call. And the third one is mapping logic. So in this case, we'll be using the opcode. So to identify after decoding which it has to execute, whether addition, subtraction, or logical operations are present in that opcode. So for that, there is a mapping is required. Just now we discussed about mapping. So what is this map? Where is this mapping? Yes, this one. Okay, so mapping is required. Why? Because in the actual machine instruction, we'll be having only a 4 bits. So to make that 4 bits to the 7 bits of control memory address, we are going for mapping, where in the first position we'll be placing 0, and the remaining bits from the machine instruction will be writing as it is, and we are placing the rest of the bits as 0, so that the address will be generated. If you go to that address, what we have here, an opcode, that opcode starting microprogram instruction will be available, so it executes those corresponding control signals. So this is about mapping. So we'll be taking 4 inputs for this multiplexer, but among that only one will be active. Either it goes in a sequence, or either it is taking the address from a subroutine register. Now let us consider inside a subroutine register there is 700. So let us consider this is activated. So that is activated means whatever that which we have in a subroutine register will be placed inside this called control address register. So if it is 700, then it goes to that control memory, the location called 700, which is present in control address register. So inside that control address register 700, where it goes, see here, so 700, it goes to control memory. So inside that control memory, each location will have 2 partitions. One is address part, and the other one is what? Which part, ma'am? And the other one is micro operations. So it has this micro operations has to be executed, and this one has to be given to the address sequencer based on which one is selected by this multiplexer. So these are the 4 approaches, but for selecting which one, so we will be having a selection lines. Hope you remembered, right? So see here, what is this 1, 2, 3, 4 is. If this selection lines, you'll be having 2 selection lines, S0, S1. Okay, so if S0 and S1, if it is mentioned as 00, that means which will be selected based on this numberings, please answer. So if internally it is not mentioned here, but you'll be having 2 selection lines, based on that selection lines, among these four inputs, one will be active. So if it is 00, which one will be activated, ma'am, among 4? If it is 00,
first one
is what?
Increment.
Yes. So if it is 00, incrementer will be activated. Like in the same way, if it is 01, conditional unconditional branching will be activated. If it is 10, if it is 10, mapping logic will be activated. If it is 11,
subroutine call.
Subroutine register will be activated. Okay, so this is about, see here, control address register receives the address from four different paths. So what are those four different paths? One incrementer, the other one is branch address from control memory, and the other one is mapping logic, and the other one is subroutine register. So which will be selected among, and will be selected as an output from this, means based on the selection lines. In this I will show with a diagram clearly so that you can understand. And some which are not needed, so many are there, but let me see this one. Okay, so this diagram, microprogram sequencer, try to see. So before that, I will show you the format. See here, okay. So this is about the size. Can you tell me the size that we have selected? Is it 4096 or 2048? 2048 into 16. Control memory size we have selected how much? Size 128 into 20. Yes, okay. So this is about, if it is mentioned as micro instruction format, then it is CM, which will be stored inside a read only memory. If it is mentioned as machine instruction, it is your the normal program, which will be stored in a random access memory. Okay, so according to this, the format of this is 2 power 11, so 11 bits is required. So 0 to 10 is for address, and 11 to 14 is for opcode, and 15th bit is for mode. So if it is 0, it is direct. If it is 1, it is indirect. So here, let me go for the micro instruction format. So see here, 7 bits it is given for address. Why? Because 2 power 7 is 128. 7 bits it is given for address. And these are all the micro operations. One, I already said that you'll be having two partitions. One is an address part, and the other one is micro instructions. So here we are using three micro instructions. So F1, F2, micro operations, F3. So here, micro operations. So F1, F2, F3 will be having three micro operations field, and the other two fields is used for deciding whether there is a conditional branching or not. So we have a condition for branching. So based on this, it branches to that location. Okay. So based on this condition, if yes, then it goes to that particular branch field. So branch field. Now try to answer. So let us consider if it is 3 bits. How many combinations you will be getting a micro operations, ma? How many or micro operation fields you will be getting? 3 bits means 2 power 3. How many micro operation fields you will be getting?
8.
So here you will be getting 8. Here you will be getting 8. Here you will be getting 8. But conditional for branching means 2. 2 means how many conditions will be getting? 2 power 2.
4.
You'll be getting 4. So branch field also you'll be getting 2 fields, means 2 power 2, 4. So all this will be having a micro operations based on that. If it is given as 0, 0, 0 in that, what it has to do. And this it is not needed to explain, ma'am. This we have discussed in the first unit, opcode. So in the opcode, if it is mentioned as add, it performs add. If it is branch, store, exchange. Okay, so that means what? In an add means inside an accumulator, the content, one of the operand content will be available inside an accumulator, and the other one we are fetching from the memory, and both we are adding, and the result we are storing inside an accumulator. Branch means we are checking the the accumulator. If it is less than 0, then the effective address we are placing inside a program counter. This is about the opcode. So let me concentrate on this field, micro instruction format. So see here, just now I said no, if it is 3 bits, you will be having 8 combinations, and this one is an 8 combinations, this one is also 8 combinations, okay? And if it is 000 means no operation, we are not performing any operation. And if it is 00001, that means it is performing add means what? Inside an accumulator, we are adding the data register values and storing the result back in an accumulator. And if it is 010, we are clearing the accumulator. If it is 011, we are incrementing the accumulator. If it is 100, we are transferring the content in the data register to the accumulator. If it is 101, what we are doing? We are placing the inside a data register. What we need to place on this address part, which is there in this data register, must be placed inside address register. Why? Because again it has to go to that particular address to get the data. So in this way, so the 0 to 11 part, we have an address. This address must be placed inside an address register. So it is placed in an address register if the micro operation is 101. And if it is 110, the program counter contents are placed inside an address register. If it is 111, that means whatever bit is present in this data register, we are placing inside the memory of the address register, which is called write operation. So this, if you see, you can remember, ma. So these are the micro operations, especially where here we are doing subtraction or addition read. We are transferring the accumulator contents to data register, and data register we are incrementing and we are transferring to data register, and program counter contents we are placing inside the data register from 0 to 10. So here also, this one is also. Here we are performing a shift left operation, shift right operation, the complement of accumulator. We are doing XOR operation. But you noted that all 00 indicates it is, there is no operation. It is none. 000 indicates it is no operation. Okay. And similarly, as we have a two fields in this, in a micro instruction format, these two fields, which is 00011011. So 00 indicates it is unconditional branch. Means in this, you will be having side to side. One is CD and the other one is BR. And if it is mentioned here as 00, so there is no need of checking any status bits. Directly, whatever it is mentioned in this branch, it goes to, it jumps to that. Okay. So, or else if it is 01, if it is mentioned, is it is indirect address bit. Indirect address bit. How it identifies is based on 15th bit. Did you remember, ma? So 15th bit will decide whether it is direct or indirect. So if it is 1, it is indicates direct or indirect. If it is 1, it indicates direct or indirect?
Indirect.
Yes, it is indirect. And the sign bit. Again, an accumulator 15th bit. So in the most significant bit, if we have a 1, that indicates the sign bit of a accumulator. So the sign bit decides the most significant bit called 15th bit. So that, based on that, if it is 10, that means sign bit of accumulator. If it is 00 value in accumulator. So similarly, a branch means 00 means it is jump, 01 means it is call, 10 means it is returning, and 11 means it is mapping. It is mapping. So mapping means what it is performing, ma'am? I want an answer. Mapping. Just now I said mapping means 11 to 14. It is placing in. Is it starting 11 to 14? Let us consider 11 to 14 means 4 bits or 3 bits.
4 bits.
So this 4 bits, let us consider it is 1011. So this 1011, are we starting from first bit position, or are we skipping the first one and placing from second? Are we placing from first bit or from second bit? Where is this, ma, diagram? This one. So we are we placing this from starting or after one bit?
After
one bit. So see here, that means 2 to 5 means you'll be having 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Why I have considered only 7? Why not the how many bits I have considered 7? Why? 128 into 20, ma'am. Yes, good. So as we have 128, I have considered only 7. In that, the first bit we'll be placing as 0, and the remaining, as we have 101, we'll be placing 11 to 14 in this register, data register. We'll be placing 2 to 5 as it is, which is 1011. Next, 0016 as it is started from 0. So if you start from 0, you'll be getting 5, 6. Next is 0016. We'll be placing a 0. Here it is mistake, ma'am. 5, 6 will be placed as 0. And the remaining will be placing from 2 to 5 as the actual opcode what we have mentioned, and the remaining places will be placing a 0. This is about when we have a map in a branch instruction, and if that bits are 0, 0, then it is map. So these are all about micro instruction format. Now let me go directly. These are not needed, my in-depth. These are all not needed. Finally, we need to go for this diagram. This is a final diagram. So here, the same concept. So address sequencer, you should draw this also. So where we'll be taking 4 inputs. So 4 inputs. One is multiplexer, one is normal incremental, and the other one is subroutine register, and the other one is external input, and the other one is branching. Okay, so here, if it is a unconditional branch, if it is an unconditional branch, then it goes directly. Yes, ma'am. I given information already, you know, ma. Second hour will also be continued by me.
Okay, so
here I will be giving break for 5 minutes, don't worry. So here we'll be having a branch. So you'll be having two types. One is conditional and the other one is unconditional. So if it is condition, we need to check. Can anyone tell me, just now we discussed, what are those? Yes is what? Yes is what? Sign bit, Z is 0, I is indirect, U is unconditional. So it has to check all those. So here, unconditional, sign, 0 flag, all has to be checked. Based on that, if the condition is true, then this test will be activated. And if this test is activated, your condition will be activated. And based on that, your selection lines will be activated. So that this condition, whatever which is present here, must be placed inside a control address register. And it goes to control, go to memory with that address and whatever it is available, and it generates a control signals. Okay, so here we should concentrate on these two selection inputs, which are very important, called S0 and S1. So based on that, if it is selecting as 0, 0, corresponding among 4 inputs, any one will be activated, called increment. In this case, incrementer will be activated. But the only concept that we need to you should be clear about is, if it is unconditional, then you are not checking a multi. We are using two multiplexers in this diagram. One is for the address sequencer, as we are giving 4 inputs. Among that, any one has to be activated. For that, we are using multiplexer. And the other one is what? For checking the condition. For checking the condition, is it true or false? For that, we are using one more multiplexer. And this multiplexer, we are giving inputs if it is condition, if you have a condition. If not, if it is unconditioned, then directly whatever which it is present in this branch called 0001, directly this we are giving as an input for this input logic, so that corresponding selection lines will be activated.